push up. Hello. Hello, everyone. I'm Jay. I'm working for New Lab company. And I'm a backend engineer. And actually, I'm living in New York. I'm not living in Singapore. So I just came here for business trip and seeking some opportunity to talk. So here I am. And a little bit introduction. I don't have a slide for myself, so I just, yeah. So I joined New Lab 3 years ago, and New Lab actually, at that time, I joined as a Java developer. So at that time, New Lab, one of the New Lab products, which is Kaku, I created those slides in Kaku. It's a diagramming, online diagramming tool. So New Lab decided to change Kaku from monolith application to microservice. So we started to use Go. So after I joined New Lab, then I become Go developer. So until now, I'm 3 years old for Go. Then, and that's why we would like to do some talk for Go, since we are, like, now we are not doing Go in our daily life. And I also have my own Meetup in New York City. So whenever you have time, if you come into New York, let me know, and perhaps we can set up a Meetup. Then you can join or you can come to talk. So yeah, it's Bowling Golang. Our New York office is located on the Bowling Street. So today I'm going to talk about Go Bing Data. How many of you already using Bing Data? So perhaps it's not this tool, but the description is like you can build all of your other file into a binary. So if you are already doing Go, so you know when you do Go build, you build all of your Go file into a binary executable file. So how about other files that require for this application? You will need to upload those file into your server, and your Go application will need to access the file system. So in this way, then you need to manage the file system on your local, on dev, on staging, and also on production. So in this way, it's really there are more things to do, more things to manage for your deployment. So Bing Data is actually doing, okay, this is not working. Okay. So usually the Go, when you do Go build, is building into the binary, but other files you will need to put into the same file system. So if you do Go Bing Data, then that will including all of the file into your Go source code. So when you build your Go file, then everything will build into one binary data. For Go Bing Data, the really good use case is for web service. So here is just a pretty basic introduction for the web service. Web service is usually including two parts. First is backend. Backend, when you run backend, is running up the Go server and also create all of the endpoints and also serve the assets file. Assets file means the front end. The front end is to display and interact with end user. So your front end actually is just file. Your file serve into the front end. It doesn't matter if it's a phone or a browser. So your browser will open up the file and execute all of the code in there, then start to load all of the assets. For example, in this diagram, on the left side is end user. The end user load HTTP, the routes path, which is slash, to our server. Our server creating the endpoint with Go language. So first, it's hitting into Go endpoint. Then, since this is root like slash path, so perhaps it's loading index.html or like home.html. So the Go backend will need to access file system. The second layer is the server file system to retrieve the file, then serve back to the client, like render the HTML, then your client will execute the HTML and start to find all of the required assets. Usually it's like JS, CSS, and image. This is not like one request to the backend for all of the assets. For all of the assets is a synchronized request to the backend. And the backend is doing the same thing again as the server file system, retrieve file, loading into the cache, and serve back to the front end. So this is standard, like usual web service. Then how, okay. Then how web service manage the files? So creating a web server in Go is pretty easy. You just write in Go, like creating an endpoint and serve the some endpoint, open up some endpoint. Then the second one, the Go will start to listen the port, and whenever they have any incoming request, the Go will start to access the file system and retrieve the like HTML, CSS, and the image files, and then serve back to the front end. So this is how like a regular server will host. On the root, usually we have a built file, which is Go binary file. Then on the same root, on the same path, you have the slash assets folder. Under the folder, you have all of the files like JS, image, and CSS. Then everything will be hosting on the Go server. So you don't need to worry about anything. You just upload your Go binary file and also all of the assets into the same path. Then the second one for Nginx to serve assets file is usually for marketing website or landing page. Your Go file doesn't need to manage the assets. Your Go backend will just need to, perhaps for HTML, to serve HTML, since when you build HTML in Go, usually it's a template. So Go will need to grab all of the file and pass into the regular HTML, then serve to back to the front end. So when the HTML rendered back to the client, and when the client needs all of the assets, actually this will go to the Nginx path. So Go doesn't need to manage any assets file. This way will be more clear, but however, you still need to manage all of the file system on your server. After you're using Go Bing data, then you only need to have one file. After you build, it's only one file. Then you take this file, upload into your server or your dev environment, then you just execute this file. So the difference between this slide and the previous slide is actually just the second one, load all of assets after creating all of the endpoints, which means after Go server runs up, everything will be loaded into the cache as a memory. So your Go code doesn't need to access the file system anymore. So you can take this build file into, you can upload to a server or build into a container, like Docker container. So everything, what you need to do, just execute this file. Then you have everything. So in this approach, what's pros and cons? The good thing is we serve assets faster, since everything, when you run your Go file, everything will load into memory. So your Go doesn't need to have time to load the file from the file system. And also, it doesn't need to know where it's located, since it's all loading into the memory and it's already binding the binary into your Go application. And it's simple deployment, since you only have one file. You don't need to manage anything. But however, you still need to manage the file system in your local. Since before build, you still have those files. After build, those files will change into, will generate into binary and merge with the Go executable file. And also it's suitable for container. Usually the container will be as simple as possible. So we are doing this way in our, all of our microservice. It doesn't matter if it's front end or back end. Sometimes back end, sometimes like some microservice only for back end, also need some files like configuration file, like JSON file. So we are doing this way. Then we don't need to worry about where is our file. Then the fourth one is we don't need to manage file system on the server anymore. But however, on the local, you still need to know where's the file when it's built into the binary. So cons is like you, like the first one, two more libraries to install. So if you don't need this system, then you don't need to install the two more library. The first library is building your file into binary. The second library is for creating some kind of file system in your Go code. So in your Go code, you don't need to think about like where is the file, but you still can use like slash sh slash like JS file. You don't need to just including binary into your code. The binary is still separate into separate code base. You don't need to know that code base. You just need to access the file system like on the server. So I will demo later. I will demo on my machine. Then you will know like how I manage all of the file system in the code, the Go code. And also, Go doesn't provide an easy way to build the file into binary. So that's why we need these two libraries to help us make our code easier. And also, you must deploy the whole application even for front-end code change. So this problem is more like monolith application issue, right? So if you are hosting a monolith Java application, if you're changing just fixing one typo, you still need to redeploy the whole application. However, Go, this language is not suitable for monolith application. So usually, if you are really good at like how to divide your functionality, then this shouldn't be an issue when you deploy your front-end code for just changing the small thing on the front-end. This should still fast to deploy it to the production. However, this is still down point, because if you are not using the binary, you can just upload a JS file into your server file system. You don't need to restart your file. Okay, cool. So the third one is it will use more RAM. It's obviously because you load in everything, all of your assets file into your cache. But however, this Go bin data is using compressed technology. So for example, our website, our Kaku landing page website, we have a lot of page. When we build everything into one binary file, it's around 100 megabyte. So it's big, it's much bigger than regular way, because Go, after you build it into a binary file, then it's usually like 10 megabyte. So it's like 10 times. But however, we found if we do this way, the speed is 10% faster, since it's not near file system anymore. And for developers, it's much easier as well when we deploy it to a production or dev environment. So how we build all of assets to the binary and into emptying into our Go source code? The first, install Go bin data library. I have the path in the end if you want to try. The second one is Go bin data assets. FS means file system, so it's like reduce some kind of file system that you can use, but you don't really need to access the file system. And third one is just using bin data is actually an command CLI tool. So you just run bin, go bin data, and all is output, and ignore, and also debug. Debug is really important for local environment. If you set debug to one, then it's not building your assets file into binary at this time. It's just adding the path into your binary data, so you still access the file system. So whenever you changing any like HTML, your assets file, it doesn't need to rebuild. It's still accessing into your local file system. Then others is just a prefix and where is your local assets file path. Then the fourth one is like a tool, like Go Generate. Like, does you all know Go Generate? Yeah, Go Generate is really a suitable tool for this case. So because every time when we build the Go file, we need to do Go bin data every time when you build. So if you write this Go Generate in your main.go on the top, then after Go Generate, you're adding the Go bin data command. Every time when you build, you also need to do Go Generate. Everything should be fine. So there's no extra step for you. Then finally, you just need to edit your code to access the file system that's created by Go bin data assets FS. So here comes to demo. So I'm going to demo a really simple website. It's like a marketing site, a landing page to introduce our product. Then I'm going to talk about how my local file system works and how the building bin data system works. Then I'm going to warp it and upload into a server. Perhaps if I have time, I can add into this Docker container, but usually like in a Docker container, we just add it the file into Docker container, so it's the same thing as you upload your file, the only file into a server. Then deploy it to a server. Today I'm using Docker DigitalOcean. So yeah, DigitalOcean is pretty easy to use, so I just created a DigitalOcean, then upload my file into DigitalOcean, everything should be good to go. So yeah, I'm going to do the demo. This is the my local code. So those things you can ignore. I'm using IntelliJ, the IDE build and node module. Actually, I add everything, like the configuration file on the root path. First is Docker file and the Go mode, the execute, the entry point of Go, and also even the webpack package that just on the root file. In this way, actually we found that this way is pretty, it looks messy, but when we get used to with this system, it's actually quite easy because everything you need is on the root. So on this file system, on the assets, I add everything into a view folder. So in the webpack, after I execute the webpack, then everything will build into the assets folder. The assets folder is after build. Then everything I need to do is adding all of the my like files into my the under the view folder. So I can, let me show you the website first. So I'm doing young dev to bring up two server. One is webpack, another one is Go. So in here, I'm actually using a webpack library called Concurrently. This tool is able to bring up multiple server, or you can execute multiple commands at the same time. So in here, I'm execute webpack and go at the same time. So you can see they have a go and also webpack. Webpack is just building of the assets file into the assets folder. Then the this is the website that I built. This pretty simple website. It's just the first page and the inner page. So how I manage of the image and also the page. So under my template folder, it's actually using Go template. So under like head, you can see I have a version that's from Go, and the home also including head and the comment.html that's using Go template. So how we building this bin data? So in the make file, I actually have this go bin data command that's building everything into this folder, and this all is output into the bin data.go. You can change this name to anything, but the folder, you can define which folder you are going to build to. So under this file, this bin.data file on the top, you can see this has list out of the assets file that's already included into this bin data. However, because I'm using debug mode, so you can see the path is actually my local path. So if I remove this debug to zero, or just remove it, then I execute again. The bin data will include the binary into the file. So in your local, you don't need to see this until you are ready to build into your production. So this file, including all of the assets into binary in this file. So also the file system works in this bin data because you can just access the file system like a regular local file system. You don't need to change the way to retrieve file. So in my Go, main.go is pretty easy. It's just creating the port and using the router.go. And in this demo, I'm using Jin. Anyone using Jin framework for your web application? Nice, they have one. So I'm using Jin because it will be much simpler in the code. If I'm using Go native language, then that will add a lot of code in here. So in Jin, it's pretty simple. You create the Go the default route. Then I set template of the file. Where is the file path? Then serve this as the file system. So static actually slash assets will be loading for all of the assets file. Then the first home page will just need to do this file name. After you have the file name, you can just load from the file system. The file system is actually just from your Go code. It doesn't need your file, like your local file system anymore. So in here, this is like extra work for us. To set a template, since not every file is just static file, right? For HTML, we need to build this with the Go, since this is a Go template. So we need to add all of the file into the system. Then when it's retrieve the file, then that will build out with a Go template. So in here, you can see when I do YAML build, it's actually build the front end first to the folder and also build the Go into one binary file. This is also open up the, so I can just do make. So first, we do Go generate, and then building up the Go binary file with Linux. Then I already prepared a server that's from DigitalOcean. Then I can just upload this file into my server. Okay. Hopefully it's fast. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's fast. Then we do SSH into the server, then find the file. So the file is binary. You can see the binary is huge, since this including all of the image and all of the JavaScript and the CSS. So execute the binary, then the server is up. Then we can just go to the server with the port. Then everything is serving in this server. You don't need to upload any other file, only this binary file. Okay. That is the demo. Then this is just helpful resource that if I will share this presentation, then you can just get in my demo code and try the bin data, because this is really useful for us. I would like you to try this as well. Then New Lab, but now it's actually hiring. So if you are looking for any other opportunity, you can take a look on our website. Thank you very much. That's all my talk. If you have any question. Yes.
Thank you for the talk.
Thank you.
I use Go in data for static data static websites. Now I'm facing a different challenge.
Okay.
We are using SQL and I have to pull in C libraries.
Actually, we have the same problem. So in this, we don't have solution. So that's why we only use Go bin data for the static file. Hopefully, if I find any new like solution, I will share. Thank you. Any other question? Thank you very much.
You want to be doing this, you can also leave.